morning. I'm Kimberly Van Scoy, live in Winston-Salem. Those storms that rolled through last night were deadly, killing two people in our state. The culprit, falling trees. One of those fell here on Reynolda Road. You can see that's behind me, and killed a man last night. Police say that around 6:30, Justin Cardwell was driving on Reynolda Road when a large tree was blown over, and it fell onto his car, a Ford Focus, and he died here at the scene. A woman was in the car, Rebecca Dobbins. She was injured and taken to Wake Forest Baptist Medical Center and is expected to be okay. This is in the 2000 block of Reynolda near Reynolda Village. Another man also hit by a falling tree, a man in Chapel Hill. Authorities say that William Morris was standing on his back deck when strong winds brought a tree down and it hit him.
Well, again, with this storm, it came up so quickly. If you have, obviously, you need to be careful of trees falling, whether you're driving or walking or in this situation, even in your own yards.
WNCN says that the top wind gust was about 48 miles an hour. Now, back here in the tri, what we have been talking about are a lot of downed trees. There's damage really everywhere. A lot of trees fell on houses and apartment buildings. Take a look at this video. This is from Winston-Salem. A big tree fell on a house on Country Club Road. This is near the South Fork Community Center. A tree also fell on a house in Stokes County on Bradley Road in Pinnacle. And in High Point, a tree fell on two apartments on Ambassador Court. That is off of East Chester Drive near 311. No word on the extent of the damage at the apartment complex, but fortunately nobody was hurt in any of those incidents. We do want to thank all of you too who sent in pictures to our U Local section. A lot of damage, and you sent in pictures so that we could see that. Here's a picture from James Anthos. He took this in Winston-Salem, and you can see the cloud as it was moving over the city. And here's one from Mount Airy. That wind blew a trampoline right on to a deck. And thank you for sending in your pictures, and you can send in more if you would like to the U-Local section of WXII12.com. And one of the things that some folks are dealing with this morning from last night's storm are power outages. In Winston-Salem, Forsyth County, there are 1,300 outages still this morning. In Guilford County, there are 700, and also 700 outages this morning in Surrey County. One of the power outages was during the ACC tournament yesterday. Boston College was playing Georgia Tech at the Greensboro Coliseum when the lights went out. That game was delayed during the outage. They did have emergency lighting in the facility, but it was the second outage at the Greensboro Coliseum in a week. Last week's women's ACC tournament game between Wake Forest and UNC was delayed when the power went out during the ice storm. Well, hopefully they'll get the lights on back everywhere today. And another thing folks are going to be doing today will be cleaning up. And it's very cold out, a 30-degree drop in the weather. So this tree here on Reynolda, it is off the road. It's not going to affect your commute this morning, but they will have to come and clean up all of this debris at some point today. And a lot of you are going to be cleaning that out of your yards as well. Nicole?
All right, Kim, thank you.